Hey guys, welcome back to Learn Python the Hard Way. Today we're going to focus on exercise 16, reading and writing files. And as always, you can find the link to the current exercise in the description below. And since this is part of the paid part of the book, you would either need to purchase a book or alternatively, of course, feel free to just follow along. So in the last exercise, we focused on working with command line arguments and reading a file. And here is a list of the most important commands that we will use when we are talking about reading and writing files. So the first one is close. This closes a file, such as saving a file basically in our editor. Then there's read, which allows us to read the content of a file. And of course, we can then assign whatever we are reading to a variable. We have read line, which in contrast to read actually reads just one line of a text file. We have truncate, which empties the file itself. And then we have write, and in parentheses here with a string, and then we're going to write that particular string to the file. And we have seek zero, which moves the read-write location to the beginning of the file. So for now, these are the most important commands we need to know. Some of them take parameters, but at the moment we don't really care about that. We only need to remember for now that write takes a parameter, which is basically the string that we want to write to the file. So let's get started by actually writing out the code provided here. So as always, we can open the terminal by pressing command space on a Mac and then navigating to the correct folder. Now from here, we can open a new exercise file, a new Python file, by entering the name of the file. And before that, I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to enter code, space, and then the name of the exercise. And of course, the exercise ends in .py, so that it's opened as a Python file in our text editor. In this case, Visual Studio Code. So let's get started by importing the sys module. In particular, argv, which, as we saw before, we used in the previous exercise to work with command line arguments. In the next step, we are going to assign those command line arguments to two separate variables. The first, of course, the name of the script, so exercise 16.py, and then the second command line argument is going to be assigned to the file name. Let's continue by using printf. And first of all, we're going to print out that we are going to erase the file name of the file that has been provided as a command line argument. Next, we're going to provide some instructions. So if you don't want that, hit Control C, which is basically the command that we would use in the terminal to end the current procedure. And alternatively, if you want to proceed, then we should press return. All right, after that, we are going to ask for some input using the input method. So that's going to display a question mark icon. And after that, the user can provide the input. Going to open the file. And we're calling the open method, providing the file name that we previously got as a command line argument. And we are providing the W parameter here. So basically, we are going to, or the W argument. So basically, we're going to open it in write mode. After that, we're going to add a print statement here, truncating the file, goodbye. And then we're going to truncate that particular file here. And regarding the target, when we opened the file in write mode, then we basically opened that and assigned the content to target so we can actually work with the file object. next, let's put out a print statement, and we're going to ask for 3 lines of input. Line 1, line 2, and we're always using the input function here to ask for user input, and whatever the user provides here is then going to be assigned to one of these variables, so line 1, line 2, or line 3. Next, we say we want to write these to the file. And now we're using the write function here, the write method, and we are actually calling write and providing the lines that we previously added, separated by backslash n for a new line. So target write line 1, the same for line 2. And then after that, of course, we always add a new line, so it's nicely separated. And finally, we're going to also write line 3. All right. And finally, let's print out. And finally, we close it. So that's the last step at the end. We close our file object by calling target close. All right, let's save that. And let's head over to our terminal here. And now just to check this here, we're going to provide this input. First of all, we're going to type out Python 3.6, which is the version of Python we're using. Then we provide the name of the script, so exercise 16 that we want to execute. Again, that would be here the first command line argument, which is assigned to the script variable. And after that, we provide the file name, so test.txt. And if we already have a file, test.txt, then of course that will be erased pretty much. And after that, we basically, gonna write a new file here with the separate lines where the content that we provide will be added to the file. So let's press enter. Actually, I have an error here. Oh, my bad. It's supposed to be import. So let's do that one more time. All right, so we're going to erase test.txt. So that's basically the first print statement here. And it replaced file name, here the variable in the curly braces, with the actual file name that we provided, so test.txt. If we don't want that, we should press Ctrl-C, which would then basically end our program here. And if you want that, we should hit Enter. And here we are stopping because we have an input function that we are calling with a question mark icon. So let's press enter right now. It says opening the file, which is this print statement here. We open the file itself in write mode and assigning that to target. We're then truncating the file, and now it's asking us to provide 3 lines of input. So the first line would be Mary had a little lamb. Now it's asking us for line 2. And then finally line 3. And let's press enter. So it says, I'm going to write these to the file, and finally we close it. So now we wrote this actual file, and if we take a look here, we can see that we have test.txt here. Let me just open that in our text editor. It's a separate tab. And we can see that exactly those 3 lines that we provided here using the input function are added in here, so they are included. And if we take another look, we can see that after each of those lines, there's the new line character backslash n that we added. Therefore, we have a new line here and also at the very end. All right, so that's basically the way we would go about opening a file in write mode, then providing some input there, some text, and then writing it to the file, and ultimately, of course, closing the file again. All right, let's take a look at the study drills. So if you don't understand this, go back through and use the comment trick to get squared away in your mind to add a simple comment. All right, I think this is pretty much clear what we did here, going through the different steps. Write a script similar to the last exercise that uses read and argv to read the file you just created. All right, we just wrote the file here and we could now go ahead and actually read our file. And just to take a look at what we did in the previous exercise, let's just go ahead and open exercise 15.py. So here in a similar way, we started out by actually importing argv from the sys module. And then we assigned the script and the file name from argv. So the command line arguments we provided and open the text file. So that's basically the first step we would need to take. So here at the bottom, for example, we could go ahead and say xd open. And here we provided the name of the text file. So we could say again, this is file name. So we can go ahead and say file name should be assigned to txt. And then we could print out the text itself. So here we could say print txt.read. So that's a second step. And then basically the last step we need to take is of course to close the file again. So we could go ahead and say txt.close. All right, let's save that. And let's go ahead and let's just execute the command one more time. And so we can enter the same text as before. So Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. It was also tasty. All right, and so here at the end now, we are basically reading the file again. First of all, we are opening it, and then we're printing it out, and then we're closing it. So that's how we would go about that. So the next step is this one here. There's too much repetition in this file. Use strings, formats, and escapes to print out line 1, line 2, and line 3 with just one target.write command instead of 6. So if we take another look here, we can see that we have 6 commands here, target write line 1, then new line, line 2, new line, line 3, new line. And we can do that in a single line by basically, it should be possible to do that in an F string. So that we can basically have the variables in there and then just add the different lines after that. So line 1, line 2, line 3, like this. And then we should be able to just remove those lines here. And for now, I'm just going to basically comment out what we just added, that we open the file again. So let's try this out and let's open this one more time to execute the command. So Mary had a little lamp. Its fleece was white as snow. It was also tasty. All right, so we wrote this here, and now we have to check if it was actually printed, so we can again say code test.txt, and we see that it basically again was written in the same way, but now we shortened our code to just take one line of code here instead of 6 different ones. And if we left this in here, then of course our file would have been opened afterwards and we would have printed it out and closed the file again, so we wouldn't have to take a look at the txt file here, but we could just have directly printed it out to the terminal. All right, the next study drill here is to find out why we had to pass a w as an extra parameter to open. And as a hint, just to take a look at that, here this is a line they're talking about. So target equals open file name, comma w. The hint is open tries to be safe by making you explicitly say you want to write a file. So basically, if we use open by default, then it would, or actually use open without a parameter here, like such, like this, then it would open the file in read mode and not in write mode. So it's basically the same as if we did this, to basically enter comma space and then quotation marks R. But if you want to open it in write mode, then we would basically do this and add comma and then W so we can actually write the file. And if you're unsure about that, we could head over to the Python documentation at docs.python.org. And if we take a look at the built-in functions, one of those is actually open here. So we could switch over to that. And here we can see the different characters we may provide. So for example, here we can see R would open it for reading, and that's also the default. So that's automatically used if we don't provide any other argument. And W here is used for to open it for writing and truncating the file first. So that's the step we would take actually to actually write the file. So that's why it's required and why we have to use it. So the fifth study drill question here, if you open the file with W mode, so with write mode, then do you really need the target.truncate, which we see here? Read the documentation for Python's open function and see if that's true. So if we head back here to the docs.python.org documentation, and let's just go back to the beginning of the page here. Here we see the different built-in functions, one of which is called open. And if you take a look, we could actually read through all of that. But what we can see here is if we take a look at W, it opens a file for writing, and it's also truncating the file first. So in fact, we wouldn't need to provide that because it automatically does that. So we could basically comment out this line or remove it, and it should still work as before. So these are the study tool sections, questions. Let's take a look at some common student questions. So the first one is a truncate necessary with a W parameter? So that's basically referring to study drill number 5. And just to verify that, let's just remove that line here. And for simplicity, let's just display that file directly afterwards. So if we execute that one more time, let me just go back here. So that is actually the command. And I'm just going to type out line 1, line 2, line 3. And now it's printing back to us line 1, line 2, line 3. So it works just as well as before. We don't actually have to provide the truncate function here. So the next question is, what does W mean? It's really just a string with a character in it for the kind of mode for the file. If you use W, then you're saying open this file in write mode, thus a W character for write. There's also read for read and A for append and modifiers on these. So A, for example, would mean that we append some additional text, for instance, at the end of the file, while W would actually overwrite the existing information that we have in there. What modifiers to the file modes can I use? So the most important one to know for now is a plus modifier, so that you can do W plus instead of W. So we can basically do this here. R plus and A plus. This will open the file in both read and write mode and, depending on the character use, position the file in different ways. Okay. And finally, that's just doing open file name, open it in R in read mode. Yes, it's the default mode for the open function. So that's also basically the answer to the question we had before here, why we had to pass a W as an extra parameter to open, because if we don't do that, then R, the read mode, would be the default mode that we're using. All right, so that's it for exercise 16, and see you guys next time with exercise 17.